Tears in Megara as woman seeks court order to evict Bobby Wine, neighbors from the land. Welcome to the Angels News Podcast, please subscribe to our news channel. When Ms. Damily Namagonda Kayondo late last year wanted to mortgage part of her land to get money to cushion her through the financial distress caused by COVID-19, Wakiso Land Board would not let the transaction succeed. I was shocked that I couldn't do any transaction to fetch me money from land that I have lived on since my childhood and yet my family was struggling to survive in COVID times, said Ms. Kayondo, a former employee of the Uganda Revenue Authority, URA. So, I took the initiative to know why, and I discovered that there was a caveat on the land. But before I could establish the person behind it, I got served with court documents wherein I was, along with 69 others, a defendant, she added. The caveat, a formal notice barring performance of certain acts on the land in question, had been lodged by Ms. Justine Nakamatna Muzizi on March 1, 2019. Ms. Kayondo claims that she got the land from her parents who in turn inherited it from her late grandfather Isaac Kasana. However, in her court documents, Ms. Nakamat alleges that the late Kasana, from whom Ms. Kayondo indirectly acquired the land, fraudulently took possession of it and registered it on Plot 38, Block 191, in Kyadondo. Through her lawyers of Kajg, Magaru, and co-advocates, Ms. Nakamat on various dates in June 2020 sued all the current occupants of the 1 square kilometer, 640 acre, mile land in Megara, Wakiso District, seeking, among others, declaratory orders for vacant possession of the suit land. The case puts at stake the ownership of land in the area by National Unity Platform, NUP, party leader Robert Kyagulanyi, alias Bobby Wine, and other residents that the village chairperson, Mr. Yekasafat Makubuya, estimates to number 2,000. Ms. Nakamat wants court to cancel all titles on the suit land so that she can repossess the property she claims to have inherited from her great-grandfather, Akulasa Matimba. She also wants the defendants to compensate her for any losses incurred. The people affected by the suits range from senior political leaders, military officers and top corporates. They're also major religious institutions and an entertainment center on the land. News of the suit struck Ms. Kayondo, a retiree who said she was born and raised on the land, like a thunderbolt. Since land matters are delicate, I had to move and that's how I ran to the LCI, Chairperson Makubuya, to report the matter, only to be notified that I was not alone, Ms. Kayondo said. It emerged that Ms. Kayondo and other 66 people on Block 190 had been served with same court documents and faced the possibility of eviction from the land and loss of whatever developments thereon should court rule in favor of the plaintiff, Ms. Nakamat. Also sued are 23 administrators of estates in Block 191 who have sold some of the land to several newcomer residents, among them Bobby Wine. The two blocks originally formed 1 square mile, an equivalent of 640 acres. However, the land has undergone several mutations and subdivisions into multiple smaller plots over the years. Since the matter covered the entire village of Megara, the affected persons, through the LCI office, formed a committee to jointly draw measures to save their land. Given the complexity of the situation we were trapped in, we formed a committee that collects views and discusses how we are to save our land. It is from one of the meetings of the committee that we decided to get a joint lawyer, Ms. Kayondo told Daily Monitor. Considering her 20-year experience as an auditor with Uganda Revenue Authority, the Megara Village Committee appointed Ms. Kayondo treasurer to the committee to muster resources from residents to meet legal costs. The lawyers have so far billed the residents SHS 20M for handling suits regarding Block 191 and another SHS 28. 6 meters to fight the Block 190 case. For a start, members agreed to contribute at least SHS 100,000 per household. The committee has so far convened 5 meetings, with the latest having been held on March 28 this year, at St. Matthew Church of Uganda, Megara, itself a target of the suit. It was also resolved that all affected persons avail, among others, all duplicate copies of documents to prove transfer of ownership, purchase of land and copies of land titles. The centralized information would then be furnished to the lawyer to aid legal defense. By the time Ms. Nakamat filed the case in June 2020, the government had through the Ministry of Lands, among others, halted all land transactions and evictions during the national lockdown period. This was because movement was hard and many people were not working besides being faced with hardships induced by the COVID-19 pandemic. Lands Minister Betty Olive Kamia at the time said, during this period of COVID-19 lockdown, there can be no land transactions, titling or land sales. All our offices are closed, hence police and other authorities should not allow any transactions during this period. Double standards. Affected Magere residents accuse Ms. Nakamat of lacking transparency throughout the transactions. For instance, Mr. Peter Njegula, the father of late comedian Patty Baitama, said Ms. Nakamat first offered to sell land with her parents' graveyard, but changed position after he raised concerns about the transaction. Mr. Njegula and wife, Ms. Mary Namudu, ended up buying a plot from Ms. Nakamat in Block 191. At first she wanted me to pay for the 2 acres on Block 190, but I declined and told her the graveyard would put me at loggerheads with many people, Mr. Njegula said. He added, so, she eventually brought me here and I signed the agreement with her sons. Land sale agreements that appear to be original seen by this newspaper indicate that the land transaction signed on May 12, 2005, was between the seller, Ms. Justine Nakamat Nimusizi, and Ms. Mary Namudu, the buyer. The agreement lists Joseph Mupi, Edward Musizi Kafiro and Peter Njegula as witnesses. On his 1 acre, Mr. Njegula has since built a house and settled his family. He has also established his poultry farm and now engages in crop production to support his family and other relatives under his care. However, Mr. Njegula is worried all this could be lost. Like Mr. Njegula, Mr. Yekasov Atmakubuya, who has served as the chairperson of Magere since 1997, fears that the 3 acres he took over from his parents would be lost. Your opinion on the woman who moved into evict Bobby Wine and his 2,000 neighbors is welcome in the comments section below. Thank you for watching in the Angels News Podcast.